trading center must open early on Saturday.
Yeah. I don't know why I'm, like, nervous because it's day two. I think it's more of a, like, excitement thing, not so much a nervous thing.
Yeah.
Like, apparently they're not letting people in because that guy is sitting out there.
That's the wrong entrance anyway.
Oh. That might be.
We want up here.
Oh, yeah. We want
number seven,
which is, like, yep, there's people standing out here, too, so they're not letting in yet. But 10 o'clock is Jump Studies Seminar. Oh, we can't miss that.
We missed last night's show, which, I mean, really the only one I was would have been excited to see is ABK, maybe a little bit DJ Clay, so.
Well, I had made the decision that I was going to stay home last night, like, stay at the hotel, but he was going to possibly go ahead and go anyways, but then he, like, got in his pajamas and everything, and he was, like, asleep. I'm like, are you still going? Because you might want to get ready to leave.
Yeah, I crashed, so needless to say, didn't get any footage of the after party last night. I don't feel like I got a lot of footage for day one either.
We got vlogception going on.
Yeah, but...
We have here on the panel, over here to my far left is Tall Jess. He is the co-creator of Morton's List, and he also did all the artwork that you see in Quest for Shangri-La, the entire game. Okay. We have also Nathan Ninja here. He's also a co-creator of Morton's List. And he did a lot of the editing and layout for Quest for Shangri-La. Okay. For those of you who don't know, Morton's List is basically was the start of Dark Carnival Games Con, or Dark Carnival Games itself. It was a company the three of us formed, and a long time ago when we had a dream to create a game based on random reality. And then to my immediate left here is none other than Lewis Simpson, co-creator of Into the Echoside. And all the way down here, sitting down right here, is Rachel Paul. She helped immensely with Juggalos Against Sanity. All right. And I, of course, am Jump Steady. I've worked on every game so far. You're just rolling randomly. So it was a totally new idea. So where you at with that, Tom?
Several cards into it. I'm definitely racing for our deadline. It's very similar to last year's deadline. We were on the same track. I've been about another 2 to 3 weeks apart drawing. We have everything squared away, and then we're going to need production time. But I think we're going to be good.
All right. Do we want to show them the art? I got it sitting right behind you.
Yeah.
We got some new pieces. For those of you who play Into the Echoside, I'm going to explain some of these to y'all because there's some new concepts coming out for the game.
Butterfly!
We're not trying to give away what the cards do exactly yet.
Yeah.
I'll explain it a little bit. But yes, the awesome butterfly. It brings me a lot of karma to see this card. The tarot cards. All right, when you look at this wonderful vision, this wonderful artwork that Tom Wood has done, I can actually hear the water flowing from the cup. Again, as Rachel was explaining, normally tarot cards are 2D artwork. They're never like brought to life like that. Okay, and the last card we want to show for y'all is the Oracle of the Three Rings.
Seen her on the cover before, but you've never got a good chance to see her up close, so this is my chance to really, you know, develop the character.
This right here is a Dark Carnival Games card. She's super powerful. She's based around the whole game. The whole premise of the game is the Nether Void is spilling forth onto the Earth, and basically you're going to her to help out. She's a powerful Dark Carnival Games character that you're going to seek help to try to turn the tide of battle.
Dark magic. The message came in Louis Luke. He thought he could fuck with this voodoo. So I turned his head to a lima bean and then flicked it off his shoulders. Promoting horse to Shangri-La. Egyptian pharaohs, Kumbata. Follow me and join us as we pray to the 17 moons.
up here on this panel. We want to thank you all for coming out to the first ever DCG Con.
Thank you all. Thank you so much.
Y'all have a bomb-ass time today and tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of the con and game on, motherfuckers.
As tired. I'm like so tired. But we got a ham and cheese sandwich. And then we picked up some cheesecake.
That looks really good too.
Yeah. Dude, we went to bed like what, 1 o'clock last night? Because I was editing the vlog. Went to bed like at 1 o'clock and we got up at what? 6:30? 7? I'm beat tired. Like there's no way I'm gonna be able to stay up till 3 a.m. for ICP. Be at the game convention all day and then drive 5 hours home. Monster to wake me up for the concert tonight. Watching Counting Cars. Kenny is editing a video for Carnival Spirits of the footage from
the seminar
that Jump Study did, and Tom Wood and like a few other people. And I'm just lounging in my boxers. The first thing I did was like pants off, shoes off, socks off, just lounging. He's lounging. Gonna try to just kind of chill, get some rest maybe before the concert tonight. Maybe get like an hour or two of sleep, if that. Probably not.
Do some napping. The alarm set so we don't miss this after party.
But like, what time is it?
Right now it's 6:00.
It's like 7:00, so we might be able to get a couple hours of sleep. Just because Beverly Kills and then the Terror Wheel is playing tonight. I'm excited. We heard from a few friends at the convention today that went last night, because we didn't go last night. that it was really nice place, like a really nice venue and everything, so I'm looking forward to it. But we just stopped at the gas station and got some Faygo and some Monsters and some Cheetos. But I got leftover salami too, so I'm gonna eat some. This car is like really cool too.
This really was a project of love, because we loved this ride the second it showed up at the shop, and now she's gorgeous and ripping up the desert the way she should be. Nice. Great work, guys.
So, do you guys remember my Faygo tote? I had it, it's for my channel trailer, but it's also for what I'm packing for the gathering last year. Basically, if you don't know, it's a tote that has Faygo labels cut out and glued on. So I'm trying to get every single flavor, and it's not something that I'm just printing off the computer, right? These are actual physical Faygos that we went and bought, hunted down, drank them, and cut the label, right? So we've went to different towns, different states. So being in Michigan, we hit up a gas station thinking maybe we can get a couple new flavors, and we found two. And was that blue jazzberry, I think it's called, Kenny?
No, it was blue raspberry, yeah.
No, the one from Georgia.
Oh, yeah, Jazz and blueberry.
It's Georgia exclusive, and his brother was coming up from Georgia, and we're like, you gotta bring us one. So that was like the one that we were like, how are we gonna get? Because, you know, Georgia, like we're from Indiana, so. It's the two that we got. So it was Ohana raspberry lemonade, and then Faygo cherry cola. Oh yeah. And that's the hoodie I got. Love it. And I got a size, like what, two sizes too big, because they didn't have the size that I exactly wanted. And so I was like, you know what, okay, that's fine. I'll just get a size bigger. And it's pretty big on me, but I'm actually glad I did that because it's super comfy that way. Hey guys. Look at that butt!
Oh my god!
Look at that butt!
Oh.
Look at that butt! Oh yeah, look at that butt!
I'm sure they're not here to look at my ass.
Why not? It's a cute butt. Y'all. Oh, you can't. That's my beautiful trunk right there. Mm-hmm. Can we just talk about how weird this headboard is?
Very, very weird.
This is like the smallest shelf. That way you can store your pens or chopstick. You couldn't really put much more up there.
Some motherfucking noise. I made this song right here for each and every one of my Juggalo family all over the world. I'm glad y'all made it here safe. I want y'all to make it home safe. Ride out with me. Put your hands up one time.
Slip and slide like a swing. Slip and slide. the steps to the break of dawn. I'm always finding bodies when I'm mowing the lawn. Drag them in the house, throw them in
the poisonous air from a smokestack. Simply in my head, fucking up my brain, driving me crazy, nuts, insane.
I'm in a little yard.